3, 2, 1. Welcome back to the channel, guys. I hope you had an awesome day and a wicked weekend. Now let's go straight into the training log. On Saturday, I smoked high bar squats. Now, before you say, oh, you know, high bar squats is for Olympic weightlifting, I am off season. This is a good time to build leg strength and work on high bar squats. High bar squats build leg strength, whereas low bar squats is an expression of leg strength. Took that from Chad Wesley Smith and Max Ada. So I went with 3 sets of 5, super easy, super light, nothing too crazy, and it moved really well, actually. I was very happy with how squats moved overall, and the fact that it was pain-free is what made it a lot sweeter. Now, I did dive bomb one of the sets, and I didn't tighten up, and one of the reps, actually, and I was in a bit of a panic, but I was able to kind of tighten up on the way up, if that makes sense. It was a little bit scary, my back felt a little bit warm, but right now, we're doing okay. No pain after training, and I was able to move just fine. Then after that, I went on to dimbo deadlifts. Now, dimbo deadlifts are one of those things that people don't see too often. It sticks within the equip lifting realm or kind of the old school guys. People think it's an RDL, but it's not an RDL. An RDL, you kind of have to go for a little bit more of a stretch. If I'm correct, because I don't really do RDLs that often. If I wanted to hit the glutes, I kind of do other things to hit them. I guess it's just dumbbell deadlifts, good mornings, pause squats, front squats. I gotta hit the glutes a little bit better. And also banded hip thrusts for high reps. RDLs don't really feel it for me, but when I do dumbbell deadlifts, I can feel both my hamstrings and my glutes engage really hard. So I did that. So the first set was for a heavy 315 with straps, but the straps kept falling, so I switched to hook grip midway through and just got rid of it all together and just finished from there. And then the last two sets were with 225 pounds, and that was just done for volume, anywhere between 12 to 15 reps. I went with 12 to be on the safe side again, because again, with my back, that was a slight scare. I wanted to be safe. So the reason why I'm going into high bar squats is to not just build leg strength, but to also get used to the bar path. Now with equip lifting, this is your torso and this is the bar. And if it's a lot lower, you're gonna have to, how do I say this, adjust, and you're gonna lose a lot of balance. When you squat with a suit on, you have to sit back. So imagine, again, bar, body torso position, and a low bar position, you're sitting back into a squat suit. You're gonna lose that center of gravity that you need to maintain balance. With a high bar, it's a lot more forgiving. Because where the center of gravity is gonna be, the starting position is gonna be a little bit weird, but again, it'll be a lot easier. When you see a lot of equipped lifters, they actually have a bit of a higher position, whether it's equipped or single ply. And that's why I'm learning high bar squats or working on them again with more frequency. We're gonna see how max effort goes on Tuesday, whether I'm gonna do a low bar for a single or 405 high reps with high bar with knee wraps on. We'll see how it goes, and I'm just gonna gauge it from here. Then on to Sunday's bench session, which was for a dynamic effort. I worked with a bit of a close grip bench. So by close grip, I mean my thumbs are from the smooth. So this is my thumb, and the knurling ends right here. The reason why I do that is, one, it alleviates a lot of shoulder pain, and two, it works on the triceps. When I tried to do a lot closer, like the finger right where the smooth part is, I felt a lot of pain on my front delt on both sides, actually. Even with complete arch setup and everything, I still feel the shoulder pain. So I stayed away from that, and again, just went with the thumbs from the smooth. Although I did the first 4 sets for triples with 30 second rest in between sets. And once those 4 were done, I took about a minute break and then went straight on to the second half of that, which again was supposed to be for 4 sets with 50 second rest periods between sets. But I was running out of time because day started a little bit later. I had to get some house chores done. So I decided to put all 4 sets together and just smoke it for a single set of 12 reps, moving it as fast as I could. And honestly, it felt great. I got the volume that I needed to get in, and I still got the intensity that I needed to get in. After that, it was all assistance work, which was super easy. It was more of a circuit style. It was upright rows with a close grip, so two of my fingers are on the smooth part, with straps, obviously, because, you know, I can only hold so much. That's a smooth piece of steel. Then I went on to the next exercise after that would be, what did I do? That would be pull-aparts, banded pull-aparts with a slow tempo, 25 reps, tricep, banded extensions, as much as I can for up to 50 reps, I believe, for a single set, just to get a good blood flow in the triceps, and then reverse barbell curls. I like reverse barbell curls because, one, it's fun, two, and you get a really wicked forearm pump with that. And I went really light, again, with it. Did about 5 rounds of those to kind of incorporate more of a HIIT-style training and to also get more cardio in without having to do cardio at all. Other than that, that's it for this training week. The Bells of Steel Power Bar review will be up this week. I did write all the script work and all that stuff that I need to get done, finalized, reviewed, and all that stuff. So that'll be coming out this week. Sometime this week, I'm not too sure when, but it will come out. But that's about it for training. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below, and peace.